So there are labels for certain guys. In your opinion, is there such a thing as clutch hitters?
I think there's guys who are comfortable in big situations. You know, I think there's guys who have had success in that situation, and because of that, they believe that they're going to come through. And there's other players who try to do too much or put too much pressure on themselves in that situation. So I definitely believe there is such a thing as a clutch hitter, but a lot of it comes down to the fact that people can skew stats to look however they want. You know, you can make guys look like they're really good in a certain situation or really bad, but there's definitely guys that are more comfortable than others in that situation.
Casey's game-winning hit was in the right spot at the right time. He didn't overswing, and I would think that would be something that you really have to keep yourself from doing in that situation. And I think back to the Marlins game last week. You had a 9-pitch at-bat. You broke two bats. You've got the potential to tie the game. You ended up getting a bloop single. You weren't overswinging and trying to hit a home run in that situation, where a lot of fans would think, well, if he hits a two-run home run, it's a tie game.
Right. I think the key is to keep your emotions in check. You know, I think when you let your emotions get the best of you, you swing too hard, you try to do too much. But when you stay within yourself, you just try to put the ball in play, get a good pitch to hit, put a good swing on it. It seems like more often than not, good things end up happening.
After the game, or after the game-winning hit, everybody was out at home plate. And I'm wondering for you guys, has anything changed since Kendry Morales went? It was a fluke thing, but he broke his ankle at a home plate celebration.
No, not really. You know, I think people are probably more aware of where everybody else is at. Obviously, everybody saw that situation unfold, and it's unfortunate for them. But I think it's important to show emotion. It's important to be passionate, and it's important to enjoy yourselves, because we haven't been having a lot of fun this year. So whenever we do get an opportunity to celebrate, I think it's important to do that.
All right. Stephen Strasburg made his major league debut, which had everybody buzzing last night. You guys may get a chance to face him, I think, next month they come in here. You've been through that whole thing when you were a rookie, and the expectations, yet the expectations on him were a lot more than they even were on you. Have you had a chance to see it, and what'd you think of this whole thing?
Yeah, our whole team was watching. I think it seems like the whole baseball world kind of stopped and watched him last night, and he was incredible. You know, to live up to the hype, I think he exceeded expectations, which was nearly impossible. I was extremely impressed. He certainly was poised and composed, and seemed to keep his emotions in check. And pure stuff wise, you could probably make an argument that he's as good as anybody ever. So, quite a debut, that's for sure.
He was the number one overall pick in the draft. You knew when you were drafted that you were going to go pretty high. You didn't, you know, in his case, everybody knew he was going to be the number one pick. I'm wondering what that night was like for you. Were you nervous? Were you trying not to think about it all day? What was that like?
I think I was excited and anxious to get it over with. You know, I think the whole process was a lot of fun. I knew that it was a step in the direction of having an opportunity to live my dream, you know, to achieve my goal of making it to the major leagues. But I didn't know who was going to draft me. It's a crazy day. There's all kinds of rumors, and you talk to a million different teams, and really, at the end of the day, you have no idea how the draft's going to unfold, because everybody's affected by the picks in front of them and signability and everything else that factors in. So I was excited that it finished, excited when the day was over with, but the whole experience was definitely a lot of fun.
I've read many times through the years about rookies, and when they first come up, now they got to carry the bags, or they got to go do this or that. In a case of when a guy gets to the majors as fast as you did, are you treated the same way as other rookies? Do they treat you a little differently?
I think it depends on the clubhouse. You know, it depends on the other guys you have around you. I think nowadays it's changed a little bit. I don't think the hazing is as bad as it used to be. For me, it wasn't bad at all. You know, I think for a lot of young guys, if you come up, if you carry yourself the right way and you're an important part of the team, I don't think people are going to go out of their way to make you feel uncomfortable. You know, the typical stuff of carrying bags and being the last guy on the plane and having to do some stuff like that, but nothing too bad.
All right, a couple more things I want to ask about. One, it was really difficult this week, I'm sure, for everybody in the clubhouse to see Jeff Suppan get released. Your whole career in Milwaukee, he's been here. You've seen how he's been treated by the fans, by the media. Was it unfair, the treatment that he got, do you feel?
You know, I think everybody has a right to voice their opinion. It's unfortunate because performance is not necessarily indicative of work ethic. You know, he worked as hard as anybody. He really was an unbelievable guy. He contributed to the community. He's a great person, so you never want to see him deal with that. Just as a friend, I felt for him. You know what I mean? It's just it's a difficult thing for anybody to go through. And when every time you come on the field, people are booing, it's definitely not going to help. You know, it makes it hard to enjoy yourself and to enjoy playing baseball. So obviously I felt bad for him, but at the same time, you know, the fans have an opportunity and a right to voice their opinion about whatever they want.
A guy your age, you don't probably think about that. At some point, somebody will either be facing a difficult decision of releasing you, or you'll be facing the decision, should I retire? I mean, there's many years down the road, but when you're at the position you are, do you try not to think about that far in the future?
Yeah, I try not to. You know, this game's extremely humbling and extremely frustrating at times. But, you know, for me, I just try to focus on being the best player I can be day to day. But I think, obviously, with Jeff's situation, with the recent Ken Griffey Jr. situation, it's something that everybody's thought about at one point or another. And for me, I think, you know, I'll know when I'm done playing, but hopefully it's 15 or 20 years from now.